Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? I hope you guys are bracing yourselves right now for some of the fastest paced Team Fortress 2 action from two of the greatest teams in all of the world right here on Payload Barn Blitz, getting ready for Pub Shoutcast number 2. I could not think of a greater map than Barn Blitz to show off these team skills, so here we are. Payload Barn Blitz, a map for champions. And when I say champions, I am dead serious that these guys are some of the most brilliant Team Fortress 2 players you are ever going to see. There was already one match which was played, which unfortunately you guys are going to miss, but you can see some of the scores right there. We are down here on a Valve server, and if I don't know if you guys know this, but Valve are the people who made this game. So to gain access to the server, these people are basically developers. Just letting you guys know what is up with this match, we are in store for a great one. This Heavy is standing on top of these boxes in an amazing defensive position right now. He is going to lay some hell down on these guys, and
oh my god, his head is off!
The medic pops his Uber to save his buddy, but unfortunately his head was already dislocated from his body, so he brings it over here onto the pyre, which is the only person available, and he's going to run around trying to light some people on fire, but no, he just pops. You gotta run, medic. Get out of here. Your entire life depends on it, medic. Go heal the sniper. We're gonna check out blue team right now. We have got Beats. He is America's top spy. He is amazing. He's gonna go crazy on these guys right now. He's needing some extra health at the moment, though, considering maybe not even grabbing the extra health, because he wants to go in on red and show off a little bit. You know, showboat on these guys. He doesn't actually need the health. He's gonna show us how it's done right now. Approaching on the heavy. Whoa! Heavy takes him down. Phenomenal aim. That was easily a headshot. Oh, the backstab on the medic. That is a huge pick. Achievement popped on that one. He has some time to take a moment to himself because he has the dead ringer and everything will always go right for him. So he's going to walk back here and decloak behind his own soldier. But it was actually a trick. That was intelligent right there. That pyro doesn't light him on fire because he was pretending to be a spy who knew what he was doing from the other team. This Heavy's been putting down a lot of defense guarding up here, but now he has got the shotgun out. Doesn't know there's a spy behind him. The spies are really doing some work right now, and of course we have Sydney Sleepers standing at spawn, but he is blocking the view of the other sniper. That seems to be quite a legitimate strategy that we see fairly often here in the public competitive league. Here we have Backburner Money coming out. Just walking over, we're gonna check his perspective because this pyro cam usually gets pretty intense right about now. Oh, and the spy takes him down. Mr. Boxman takes down that money. That's all fine and good because we have got Daddy's rusty uncle showing off the pyro cam. Instead, he's defending the cart to make sure we can push blue team right through here without a problem. Look at him. Showing off his fancy hats. His hats are a little bit too fancy. We shouldn't be watching you. I don't like you anymore. We're gonna watch this, who's this guy? This medic? No, you're not worth watching either. You're mostly dead. We're gonna watch Beats, because Beats has proven himself already to be completely capable of destroying pretty much any foe, anywhere. Doesn't even worry about the backstab. Takes him down. Just keeps swinging that knife. He's down. This demo man. Oh, you could have got him. You were so close, but I think that was actually a demo knight staring right at you. Here we have one of the blue engineers coming out of spawn. He did not put down a teleporter. He's thinking about it. He's considering it. Trying to choose optimal position for the teleporter for his team. Or maybe he's going to run ahead and try and set up a defensive position to make sure they can easily push this cart. There goes down the sentry. Makes his decision. And he's going to wait here for the ammo to respawn. Let's go over here and start building this. Oh no, you gotta stand a little bit closer. There you go. You're gonna start building that sentry. It's going to be able to defend this cart position right here as the cart actually gets pushed further and further away from this defensive position, but at least you know nobody will show up behind him. And as soon as these lights stop blinking, we will be able to go ahead into this area over here. But here we have spies in position already for the blue team, waiting up very far, and red team standing way, way, way back here. They don't really want to contest what is going on up ahead. The cart, it's a little bit frightening. So we've got this spy, you know, just waiting for red team. But I think red team knows, and that's why they're hanging back so far. They really don't want to get into this fight. This sniper, he didn't want to fight. You can actually see way back there right now, there is a spy going for all the backstabs, but the pyro catches him, lights him on fire, and that didn't work. We've got Magora, the ultimate medic, losing track of his heavy. There he is, he's right there. We're gonna follow this heavy into battle and see how it goes. Through the medic's perspective, oh, and he is down heavy. Is he going to turn around to protect him? Oh, I gotta go all the way back because I'm a bad camera person. No, he's already dead. How do you feel about that?
Yes, I like this new weapon.
Yeah, heavy, I know. Is that all you talk about?
Yes.
It's okay, we've got another red team spy going in right now. Inferno Titan 807. 9. He's walking back. It looks like he bumped somebody, so they might see him. Oh, he's in a bad position right now. This soldier knows he's there. He knows he's somewhere. He's gonna find him. Or maybe he won't find him, and nobody will find anybody, but here comes the pyro, and he cleans him up. I am not liking you at all. You're like the only person with a hat, and you are ruining what would have been a really fun moment. Spyro's rules is going down the drop-down. He's gonna appear right here, show up behind some red people, and start blasting them away with the shotgun, doing maybe 8 damage on that heavy. I'm sure he won't be healing that anytime soon. Back here we have the red team engineer setting up for them. They have a dispenser, they have a sentry. I think this is pretty much one for the red team. There are 8 minutes left in this match. 8 minutes and 45 seconds. But there's a level 3 sentry, which is basically undefeatable unless this spy can get something done. We are going to take a look at Mr. Boxman. Where are you going, bro? You're going to stand up here on this rock? It is your primary directive to take care of that sentry. That is all you need to do right now. I'm following you around. You can kind of see him right there. The sentry takes down a soldier, and oh, we're going to go up here, and this sniper is surely... And now that this sniper is out of the way, we can use our imagination to pretend that Mr. Boxman was actually successful in taking down the sentry, and he used its mind to rip it apart. There you can see the remains. Yeah. Beats X. X. He's got ultimate X's. You know he is triple X rated. Coming in here looking for a position to snipe from, but isn't really sure which window he wants. No, does not want to snipe from the window. He jumps back down, regains his positioning, is going to come over here and help push the cart. No, he's going to jump on top of the barrel. Jump on top of the barrel. Please make something I'm saying be correct. You can do it. You got to crouch when you jump. Getting angry right now. Sick headshot on the medic. Takes him down immediately. Then gets another headshot right on the heavy right there, but is taken down by the sniper. And Inferno is going for the backstab on the demo man, who doesn't even know he's there, but can't pull it together and decides to cloak in the corner. And that is it for you. You are dead, sir. We are seeing some amazing plays being made right here in the last area of Payload Barn Blitz. This match might actually be coming to a close right now while we're taking a look at Teehee. It is a soldier with a direct hit trying to hit a few things directly, and Shoot Man running onto the card. It is all that he can do as Blue Team does their best to push it in, and this could be game over right now if not for the Purple Pizza Turtle using the Phlogistonator and able to block the card, pushing everybody off of it. Now he is gonna go flog yo mama. This cart actually looks like it's in. It's like it's on one wheel. One wheel is all that is letting this team not lose the game. That matters so much. Oh, we are going the full-on heavy strategy for red team. We've got heavies that are even guarding the spawn over here. Nobody is going to get in here. Nobody from blue team. We've got heavies going back in, grabbing more sandwiches and standing on the cart for extra defense. We've got double the heavy over here. Brass Beast charged up, ready to go. Looks kind of upset because he's on fire. The fire is going to take care of that, and the heavy is going to walk forward with 100 health and shoot at these guys. He's probably going to die. He is dead.
I like this new weapon.
X beats with a sick headshot on the heavy. Gets another on him. Your bizarre bargain is leveling up. It's officially awesome. Take another shot. That guy, he's not even moving. Get one of these heavies. Get one of these heavies for me. Do it, bro. Do it, bro, right now. Do it, bro. Yeah, takes a shot on him. He finally decides to come back. He is done guarding the spawn. He needs to help. But no, it's a little bit too late. Blue team has won against all odds. They are going to continue on to the Olympics. You can see them in 2014. Summer Olympics. Let's go.